Hello everyone, welcome to this new video. I will show you how to embed the Report Server's Report Designer in an application using React. The Report Server is a powerful application that allows you to store, manage, and deliver reports for your users. Embedding the Report Server in your application provides seamless access to your reports without having to switch to a different application. You need two items to embed the designer, as it is not possible to integrate it simply with the frame. Reporting service. This service is used to interact from your application. Reporting tools. Use the JavaScript Report Designer from the Bold Reporting Tools. The designer is also built using the same service. For prerequisites, make sure that your development environment has Node.js version 8 and above, NPM version 3 and above. Let me start by creating a React application. I run this command to install the Create React App globally in the command prompt. The Create React App is a simple way to create a single-page application that provides a build setup with no configuration. To create a new application, I run this command. The Create React App command adds React, React DOM, React scripts, and other dependencies required to create an application. Next, I change the directory to the React Application root folder. Then, I install the type definition of the Create React App and Bold Reports React library in the application. Then, I open the root folder in Visual Studio Code. This is my choice of an editor for editing the code. Next, I need to add the script reference. Bold Reports needs a window.jQuery object to render React components. I create a new file and name it globals.js in the src folder. I copy the code from documentation and add it to the globals.js file. Next, I open the index.js file. I copy the code from documentation and then replace the existing code in index.js. Next, I want to add the scripts file. First, I open the index.html file from the public folder. Then, I copy the scripts from documentation and add them in the head tag. Next, to add the report designer control, I open the app.js file. I copy the code from documentation and replace the existing code in the app.js file. Now, configure the report server in the app.js to render the report designer control. Service URL, report server URL, and service authorization token are required to perform API actions with the report server. Okay, let me add them one by one. First, I add the service URL. This URL specifies the web API service URL. It contains the server, service, and the REST API names. The format is http://reportserver/domain/reporting/reportservice/api/designer. In this demo, since I have hosted the report server on my local machine, I specify the domain as localhost, along with the port number in which I am hosting it. You can use your own report server domain. Reporting/report service/api/designer represents the service name. Next, I add the report server URL. Here, it specifies the server name and site information. The format is http://reportservername/reporting/api/site/site name. As before, I set the report server name as localhost along with the port number. Site/site1 represents the site from which I am going to load the report in the control. Since I load the designer control from site1, I specify site/site1. You can specify your own. Finally, I need to add the service authorization token. For this demo, I am going to use the service authorization token report server UI. You can also generate a service authorization token using credentials and an embed secret key. I have provided the link in the video description for your reference. I log in to my report server. Next, I open the user profile page. I click the personal access token from the top panel. You can change the token expiration period here. I click the generate token button and confirm it. Once the token is generated, I copy it. Finally, I add the service authorization token. I save the file. Now, everything is ready and the report designer can be loaded. In the command prompt, I run the command. It launches the application in the default browser at this URL. You can see that the control is loaded in the browser. Here, you can add some report items and save it in the report server. In this demo, I showed you how to embed the report designer from the Enterprise Report Server. You can also embed it from the Cloud Report Server. I have provided the documentation link in the video description. In this video, I have shown you how to create a React application, add scripts to render the report designer control, and initialize it. There's a link to the documentation with the steps in this video. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.